tell my children, and the times that I had to make decisions in my home because me and my wife couldn't agree, I said, if it doesn't work, I'll be the one that pays. Because let me show you your power. In Genesis 3:17, when God got ready to deal with Adam, I want ladies to hear this. But watch this, ladies. When a man is fathered and built up, hell can't touch him. Do you hear me? Hell cannot touch him. Watch this. So what did the devil say? God, the devil said, since I can't mess with him. Watch this, ladies. Let me get a greater power. He said, let me get who's more powerful than I am. Let me wait on that woman. Because a woman can build him up, or she can. My sister. He said to the woman, he said, I will greatly multiply your sorrow and your conception and the pain to bring forth children, for your desire shall be for your husband, and he shall rule over you. Look at me, y'all. He said, and your desire shall be for your husband, and he shall rule over you. God says, you have an issue. And that issue is, you want to control. And if you say this is wrong, then you're telling God he's a... Why y'all looking off? Now here's the problem. This is the problem that happens with single mothers who are trying to raise sons. Please understand this. A man was created outside the garden. Which means I was created in the wild. My most productive work is done in my creative wildness. I don't need Ritalin. I need you to educate yourself on another way to teach me because I'm gifted. And there's a whole new generation of young folk that have been raised that the old methods of teaching will not work. Sit in your seat. No, I can't sit down. I've got to get up and move. And you need to learn how to teach me because I'm gifted of God. Don't drug me. Because you don't want to learn that I'm unique. And so now you want to put me in special education classes because you don't want to upgrade the educational system. I'm a wild man, but everything God did, he did to a wild man. He's longer than wild. Oh, good God Almighty. What's this? So you're trying to make your sons sit up and be polite. And when the testosterone hits them, round about 13, that little rule stuff and color in the box starts to frustrate them. Because their creativity is outside the box. And when you're sitting there and you're trying to control, I ain't trying to control him. Yes, you is. And the worst thing a man can say to his wife is, you're trying to control me. What? I bet you, I ain't trying to control you. I'm just trying to get you to do right. Now sit right there. And so in all of that, there was a separation that came. And Eve went from being the queen of life to just my baby's mama.
instead of recognizing who they are so you can help them in what God has already called. And if you help them in what God called them, you will be satisfied. But as long as you are fighting and trying to get you a man, are you single folk? Do not marry because you just want a man or a woman. That's not the purpose. It is to help each other fulfill the destiny call that God has placed. And until we get the higher calling, you will always be miserable in the flesh.
But if little boys never see men make decisions, little girls never see the strength of a man who can stand and take a licking. That's why I say it's hard to be a man, because sometimes we got to take a whole thing on and we don't know how it's going to end up. It is hard to be a man, but somebody got to be one.